Okay, you guys, welcome. Those of you who are tuning in, I'm going to go ahead and warm up with you.
So it's up to you to characterize the whole thing so that it feels good. ship, something, you know, if anything, or a whale, or a, you know, name anything, it shouldn't be there, but it is. Okay, then we go to romantic litigation, because it becomes fantasy. So at the far end, you get all of the things all the way to, I suppose, you carry this all the way to manga and all the other videos and drawing that are very popular. So, let's see. Characters are scenes idealized to a personal or conventional wisdom. Normally hostile characters or events don't arrest them. And when you see it, there's one in here that will show that. See, any character or object depicted as heroic and larger than life. Those are all the romanticized things. And you could probably add a few to the list that I didn't think of, but I think that generally covers most of the big ones. Tranquil. Okay, that, like I said, that becomes lonely, finally desolate, and then bleak and horrifying at the far end. Threatening elements are either distant or non-existent. Okay, so that if it, like you could have crashing surf, but if it's far enough away where it's not going to hit you, the scene becomes tranquil. And you say, oh, that's okay. Your wife comes up, no big deal. You know, the threatening elements, dissonant, little rapid movement indicated anywhere. That's another hallmark of tranquil. Small or resting human presence in a scene. So in other words, you don't want great big people in the foreground, is not going to be a tranquil situation. And then on the far shore, leaning up against a tree, you know, just their heads poking out of the water, that's tranquil. Okay. So you want to keep the human presence small in the picture, and usually someone is. Okay? So that's the basic, that's step one in analyzing where you want to go with your stuff. So, this will be followed. Today the big focus is going to be on the genres, and we're going to touch briefly and in passing on motifs, but there are 15 motifs that also fill with this. And then when we get past the motifs and the genres and getting those to dovetail so that your story can exist, there are certain motifs that will not be appropriate for certain things. And I did on the last page, I did some little thumbnails, these are little dirty little quickies. These were like probably 2 minutes piece. When you start thinking about it, to where they are. Took more time to figure out what I had drawn a picture of and describe it than it did to actually do it. But I talked briefly about certain motifs that where your story, your situation that you're going to be trying to portray simply cannot exist. Like, if I want tranquil, I think the example I give in here is a pinnacle, the top of the Matterhorn. Just to be ridiculous. It's tranquil if you look at it from a distance, but if you put somebody up there, it's going to be tough to make it look tranquil, because that's a scary spot to be. But you could have somebody really tough guy just sitting down there, you know, his knees up under his chin, and you know, legs around him, just looking at the scene. Then it could become tranquil. So, or the pinnacle itself could become the center of interest. But it's very important for us to know in anything we do, you know, what the center of interest is. What am I selling? You know, am I selling the Coca-Cola or am I selling the table? You know, I mean, you got to know. And so prioritizing and saying, okay, I know what my character is, I know what I want to be doing. And now you start asking yourself these questions and you start playing with it. Let's go through these sketches and see what we can learn, if anything, from all of this. Okay, first one, warfare, obviously. We need to have a just some guerrilla robots here that are making just to make the whole thing, you know, tracers and lasers flying through the air, all kinds of thick, fractured stuff in the picture. Jagged shapes. We will go into this later. Jagged shapes mean trouble. And soft, smooth, what we've got here, we've got hang up here. This basically, notice this goes skin, chain, boom, like that. So we've got three different angles for the weapons, and then we've got these beams coming from these weapon tracers coming from the other direction. It balances the general movement from the other. So we've got opposing angles. And so we've got balanced composition that does not become stiff, even though it's balanced. So that's conventional warfare. That's a big topic in hostility. Natural disaster, the tsunami coming right up the street. So it's a natural sign, a natural disaster. You got copies of these in your hand.
So when you push the push gate, towards the genre that you're doing, like flex warfare,
so
that's a lot of ankle.
Hard flood jags. Yeah, you want to favor that. Yeah, I mean, smooth shapes, curves, things like that. I bet you talk more about romantic situations, you know, literally romantic situations. A better representative with softer things. You know. With the tsunami, what we're talking about is scale more than anything else. And the lightest light in the picture is the breaking wave, and obviously just the whole idea of the thing. Pretty terrifying, so you know, a lot of extra work. I tilted the horizon slightly, which is all that people have been in my class before, the purpose of that angle, and that usually means trouble. So that's it. The camera means if you want the viewer to be a little upset, or maybe really upset. This is what for all of
us. Yes, yes. Go ahead and just grab that. Good to see you. Yeah, no worries. How you doing?
Good. How you doing?
Good, man. Just relax into it, and we're just getting the warm-ups in, so.
Falling or anything else. feel like we're falling away from something rather than if you draw it too straight, it takes all of the energy out of the situation. Okay, so that's all of our basic possible energy. I didn't overdo it on that. This is the hostile category. But this is almost moving into mysterious, which is our next category. So we're halfway between violent situation and that one of those silhouettes that you weren't expecting in the mist, you know, that is all of a sudden in your face, a big tank going over the top. They're just beginning to react. And you notice a couple of things I'll mention along the way is that this white area that it's still red begins. It starts out dark value and it moves the lighter behind these dark characters. That's typical smoke, dust, anything like that. You get that kind of effect. Also notice that these old posts with the barbed wire, they fade away into the distance to accentuate the feeling of this thing a little distance away. And so it's just a certain emphasis. These are also moving. Okay, this is mysterious. So we've got this couple of kids trick-or-treating down below, just, you know, getting their candy. And the neighbor's candy is this nameless horror up in the street. And so nothing else really needs to be said. It's mystery pushed to the point of being near or not quite, but really close. Anything unexpected, in the case of this particular case, shapes that almost resemble something else that shouldn't be there, especially in an endless series, as if they were assembly line produced. So there's something very wrong here that would automatically put you on some kind of guard. So anything, any really unusual shapes that you can't identify. Serious, again, moving towards, it's definitely in the spooky area, and moving right on into horror as soon as it gets a little bit closer. A lot of the little quickie, rough stuff drawn in here is, these all work their way into motifs of one kind or another. So deal with that as we move on. Obviously, a shadow of the Grim Reaper on the wall with an electric nightgown wall. Yeah. So is it this again? It's just a control of light and shadow, again, so that we make sure the dark is always reading against light, and light is always reading against dark. It'll take a lot of practice to get to the point where you see these problems coming before they happen. Shadow of a hand or a claw on something that puts it totally out of scale with something that's already totally out of scale. So if it's a lousy drawn hand, what do you want? but the chicken claw, we don't need a better word for it. So anyway, again, with the mysterious, it's the unexpected, things that are out of place, out of scale, out of time, and totally can't be understood. That makes them automatically mysterious. A place that should be full of people, probably there. Nobody in the parking lot, nobody in the car. Okay? Pathway that disappears into the distance. That's just simple language. This makes you feel, and things just feel not quite safe and secure, but no real reason to panic yet. No reason to panic yet.
Thanks, Miguel.
Silhouetted against the haze.
All right, everybody, just go ahead and take a break and tune your pencils up, relax. If you don't know how to sharpen a pencil, let me know and I'll come around and give you some assistance. And we'll just kind of get into the class and just start getting down to business.